So, ladies and gentlemen, we have a very interesting conjunction which is happening in the sign of Capricorn. From now on, I see till 13th of February. It's the conjunction of Sun, Mercury and Saturn in the sign of Capricorn. So, we know that Sun and Mercury are friends and so are Mercury and Saturn. But Sun and Saturn are not friends. In fact, they are enemies, right? So how will this conjunction affect us? So this is a very interesting conjunction which is there till the next 1 month, because if you see, Saturn has been in Capricorn from long time, and if you see Mercury, he's also retrograde, right? So therefore, now Mercury is going to behave a bit differently, not the way as if he's in Capricorn, right? And currently, we are celebrating Makar Sankranti, Lohri, Bihu, all these festivals in different parts of India. So many, many happy celebrations of Makar Sankranti and Bihu and Lohri, wherever you are, whichever part of India you are, whichever tradition you belong to, celebrate these beautiful Vedic festivals with joy, and try to understand the meaning and significance of these festivals, because these festivals are based on the transits of planets, right? Of course, this year is a special year, because every year when Sun enters Makar Rashi, that's the celebration of Makar Sankranti, right? But now Sun is not just alone here. He's with Mercury, but he is with Saturn, just like last year, right? So therefore, Saturn is the Lord of Capricorn, and this degree of Capricorn where Sun is currently transiting is known as the Abhijit Nakshatra, which is the Nakshatra of Lord Vishnu, actually, right? So Abhijit is a very powerful Nakshatra. It is said anything that you start during Abhijit Nakshatra is bound to be victorious, right? Or rather successful, I would say. So therefore, if you have any plans related to the houses that Sun rules in your chart, or the houses which Mercury rules in your chart, okay, Mercury rules two houses and Sun will rule one house in your chart. So if you have any specific plans, any long-term plans, then this is the best time to implement that, right? Because whenever you do something in Abhijit Nakshatra, now you could say, you know, oh, moon transits Abhijit Nakshatra, you know, once every month. But then Sun is going to transit, in fact, he is transiting now in Abhijit, and Sun transits for a bit longer time, right? And Sun is a very important planet, because it is the powerhouse of our life. It's the source of energy. If there's no Sun, then there is no energy, actually, okay? So therefore, when you have this powerful conjunction, this transit which is happening along with Saturn, this becomes very important, because whenever Saturn is involved, you have to see things from a long-term perspective. You have to ask this question to yourself: what is your purpose, right? Of course, Saturn does not show purpose, but Sun shows purpose. But why do I say purpose? Because whenever Saturn is involved with any planet, then you got to understand that whatever it is, you will not reach the destination as you expect in that amount of time that you expect. It will be delayed and there will be setbacks that you get, right? So therefore, Sun represents purpose. But now you have to actually ask, what is your purpose, right? So you have to ask this 3 times, 10 times, at least 3 to 5 times. What is my purpose? What do I want to do? And why do I want to do it, right? Because see, many times people tell me that they set New Year resolutions, New Year goals, but then they cannot achieve them, right? Because they get obsessed with a particular goal, right? So suppose you have a YouTube channel, you get obsessed with a goal, like I want 10,000 subscribers, for example, or 100,000 subscribers. But that is not very good, because not that it is wrong, but you should not put that as a goal, because getting subscribers or getting external achievements is not just based on your own actions. It is also based on your previous karma and, you know, that your destiny and all this, like prarabdha and all this. So instead of goals, if you get obsessed with your purpose, right? Ideally, you should not be obsessed with anything. But if at all you want to be obsessed, if at all you want to have a resolution, then the best resolution to have is to have a resolution of your purpose. So for example, you are opening a YouTube channel, right? Why have you opened the YouTube channel? Why? What is your purpose? Do you want to share stuff, or you have your business, you want to like showcase your services, or you want to, you know, speak about something, you want to display some, you know, creative work or whatever it is, or some talent that you have, whatever it is, right? But what is your ultimate objective behind doing this? Is it just to gain some followers, subscribers? Well, then it's not a very good goal, good purpose, because subscribers will come, they will go, and they may come fast, they may leave fast also, right? So therefore, your goal, if you have a YouTube channel, it should not be to gain subscribers. The goal should be to share content and to improve people's lives, and my life also. So therefore, when you have that purpose in mind, then it becomes easier for you to gain subscribers, because then you are very natural, you are just being yourself, and whoever feels comfortable with you, they will come and associate yourself themselves with you, right? Rather than if you just get obsessed with, you know, milestones, like, you know, 10,000 subscribers or 100,000 subscribers, then you may get them today or tomorrow or maybe after 10 years, right? Who knows how many subscribers you will get when, right? So similarly, if you are working in a company also, right? So if you are just concerned about getting promotions, but you are not concerned about doing the work, right? So then that doesn't work, because the more, of course, just because you do your work, it doesn't mean, you know, your boss will promote you all the time. You have to push and you have to negotiate with your boss, right? That is also very important. But these things will only help you if you have performed well. If you have not done any work, you have just been sitting and not doing anything, and then you go to your boss and say, "Oh, my dear boss, my dear sir, my dear madam, please give me this promotion. I think I deserve it, you know." But the problem is your boss doesn't think so, right? So therefore, do your part and try to ask this question to yourself: why am I doing this? What is my ultimate purpose, right? And if your purpose is very selfish, if it is only to yourself, then you are bound to face roadblocks during this transit, because Saturn tells you that only you don't matter, the others also matter, right? And that is why he gets exalted in the sign of Libra. Why does he get exalted in Libra? Because Libra is that sign where you are forced to think about other people, right? So exaltation means the highest level of maturity is required, right? Only then you can understand who Saturn is, what Saturn is, what he does, what he wants to do, what he is good at, what he is bad at, right? So therefore, ask yourself this question: what is my purpose? Why at all I am doing something? Why am I in this career? Why am I doing this, you know, health strategy, this diet strategy? Why do I visit this place? Why do I have these friends? Why do I have this spouse in my life? Why do I, you know, just do anything and everything? Why do I just do that, right? And also, because Mercury is retrograde, therefore you could feel that, of course, I mean, typical Mercury retrograde, we all know, right? It's like your friends, some old friend will call you back, or you will sign some contract which you will regret later, or, you know, some electronic appliance will go off, right? Something of that sort. So we all know typical Mercury retrograde, but the thing is, this Mercury retrograde is with the planet Sun and Saturn. So one shows abundance and purpose, which is Sun. One shows scarcity and limitations, right? And lack of or self-doubt, basically. So therefore, because Mercury is also involved in the Sun Saturn conjunction, therefore you will get a feeling that just by thinking about your purpose, it will not solve the problem, right? because Mercury shows your thought process, but it also shows a reason based action, right? So you also have to take action. So for example, if you have a group of you have a company where you are working, and you try to ask yourself, what is my purpose, why am I doing this work, and then you find an answer but you still stay there, then this will not help you. You also have to take action, right? So if your purpose is not very good or not very clear, either in these circumstances, one of the two, then you will be forced to make a decision, right? Either you stay there or you leave the work, right? Same is with married life, or is the same is with any part-time work, part-time job that you do, or it could be with anything. You have adopted a health strategy, right? So for example, you have started doing yoga, for example, but why are you doing it? Because you want to look good, you want an attractive physique, you want to seduce the opposite sex, or you want to get in the good books of the opposite sex. Is this the reason? As it is for most of the people, then you are in trouble, because today you may be in the good books of the opposite sex, but once you get old, then they may not keep you as in their good books, right? That is what we see. People who are very attractive, they remain attractive for 10-15 years, and then after 10-15 years their beauty dwindles and their followers leave them, or maybe some old followers who always stayed with them, some that 5-10% of your eternal loyal follower base will be there with you, right? But 90% of your followers will either unfollow you because you are not that attractive anymore, right? So or they will find somebody who is more attractive than you, right? That's how it is. That's how the modeling fashion industries, it's like a competition based on attraction and superficial personality, basically, right? That is how the entire industry is sustaining, and that is why you will see. Anyways, that's a separate topic, but what I'm trying to tell you is, what is your motive? What is your purpose? What do you want? Is it something which the scriptures advise us, right? For example, if you are only doing yoga or only doing exercise because you really want to be in the best shape of your life to impress the opposite sex, is this something which the scriptures suggest us to do? Well, certainly not, because this will drag us down to animal species, because one of the primary traits of animal life is sexual attraction, right? So therefore, human life is primarily meant for spiritual inquiry, athato brahma jigyasa, right? As Vyasdev writes in the Vedanta Sutra, okay? So human life is not to be meant for just running behind the opposite sex like dogs and cats and pigs and hogs, because that will glide us down to animal species in the next life, right? Human life is primarily meant for spiritual realization. So therefore, any purpose that you have which is devoid of the principles of scriptures and is contrary to the word of God, that purpose is going to make you miserable in life, right? It could be anything, not just beauty, not just money, it could be anything, it could be anything and everything, right? But that will make you miserable. So therefore, check your purpose and try to see if your purpose is actually in line with who you are. Are you happy doing what you are doing, right? So if you are, then very good, continue doing that. But if you are not, then because Saturn is also present, so he will make your life difficult to the extent that you will leave that if you do not have the right purpose, right? So therefore, the next month, the next 28 days is a fantastic time actually to ask yourself this question: why do I do this? What do I do? What do I do and why do I do this, right? Why we do what we do? That is the primary question that we need to ask ourselves, right? And once we get this right, then everything else will fall in place. All right, so thank you very much for your patient hearing, and if you're new to the channel, then please subscribe to it down below. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your horoscope, then please go down to the description section to my website exoticastrology.in to book a personalized consultation. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him.